6 million ways to die. Choose one. 6 million ways to die. Choose one. Six million ways to die. Six million. 6 million ways to die. Choose one.
Hi. If you've been watching up to this point, you know that all things will hit the ground at the same time. Am I a liar? Yes, but that's not the point. Things don't always hit the ground at the same time, but that's because there's something around us that we just can't ignore. It's called air. And air isn't nothing, it's something. And it's because it's not nothing that it is something. When you try to push away fluid or gas out of the way, the air or fluid will push back with an equal but opposite force. That's Newton's third law. If you want to feel, ow! If you want to feel air resistance, just go like this. Or stick your hand out a window. If there's no air resistance, like on the moon, both the objects are going to hit the ground at the same time. But on Earth, there is air all around us. And that resistance that air provides is the result of the surface of an object colliding with all the little tiny air molecules underneath of it. The more surface you have, the more air molecules are going to collide with it, meaning the more force. Air resistance depends on a lot of different factors. For those of you who are more mathematically inclined,
we start with Newton's second law and find the relationship between velocity and time during the interval before the terminal velocity is reached. We take the positive y direction to be downward and neglect any force associated with buoyancy. So then Newton's second law just gives us the sum of all the forces equal to the mass times the acceleration, gravity minus k times the velocity, which equals the times the acceleration in the y direction, where k is proportionality constant, depends on the shape and the size of the object and the properties of the fluid. So we can rewrite the acceleration as the derivative of the velocity with respect to time, and then rearrange terms and replace mg over k with the terminal velocity, which we know is mass times the acceleration of gravity over the proportionality constant. We integrate both sides, so the velocity in the y direction is equal to zero when the time is equal to zero, so which then integrates the one minus the velocity in the y direction over terminal velocity, which equals the natural exponential raise to the negative k over mass times the time. The derivative of vy gives the acceleration in the y direction as a function of time, and the integral of y as a function of time.
But the proof is left for the reader. For the rest of us, if you have objects that have the same shape, objects that are heavier, the one that has the more weight, will fall faster because it provides more of a net force against the air pressure. If you have two objects that are the same weight, then the one that's more aerodynamic will fall faster because the one with the larger surface has more area, therefore interacts with more air when it goes down. Check this out. If I put this ball of paper on top of this book, both items are going to fall at the same rate. Another important factor is speed. The faster something is moving through the air, the more air resistance it's going to feel. When the force of gravity and the force of air resistance are equal, you stop accelerating and you hit something called terminal velocity. You stop picking up speed, and so you start to fall at a constant velocity. That constant velocity is called terminal velocity. So if you jump off a chair, you're not moving fast enough for both forces to balance each other out. The only way I would ever hit terminal velocity is if I jumped out of an airplane.
Nuts.
Yeah.